They didn't like it. I did another one and took some suggestions. I did another one. They liked it. And I got 10 shows to fill the summer. When the fall came, they said, can we run your 10 summer shows again? And I said, sure. So they did. About halfway through that run, which took like 2 months, I got a note from them saying, we've done the fall book, which was the ratings, and you're the top rated show. Would you like to do it for the whole year? And I said, wow, that would be amazing. And I started that. And now we have done 16 years of incredible shows. So we're going to take you back to that time. I haven't heard this in a long time either, obviously, in 16 years. It has my wife at the time, Denise McCann, who was helping with the show then. So we're going to go back to my story in Winnipeg. So let's kick this off with what really got me into rock and roll, because rock has been my life. Here we go back to July 2005. My story starts in Winnipeg, Manitoba. Yours might have started in a little town in Saskatchewan or Ontario or New Brunswick or British Columbia. The first time you heard rock and roll on the radio. I'm going to go to the first time I heard rock and roll played on CKY in Winnipeg and CKRC, the local radio stations, and the stations I used to listen to late at night, being in Winnipeg, the top of the Great Plains. I'd go to bed at night and have this little rocket radio, and I would listen to WLS in Chicago, WNOE in New Orleans. I'd hear Wolfman Jack, and they played this most incredible music, rock and roll. I grew up playing violin in Winnipeg, and it was very structured music. It was classical music, and I'd go to these country and western shows when they came into Winnipeg to see the fiddle players, Ray Price and Patsy Cline. They all had great fiddle players. And on one of these shows, this country music guy came out with long, curly, blonde hair and sat at the piano and played You Win Again. It was Jerry Lee Lewis. After he finished that song, he did a song called Whole Lot of Shaking Going On. He jumped up, his hair that was all neat went into gigantic locks all over his shoulders. He knocked over the piano stool. This was never done at the Grand Ole Opry or Western shows. The piano stool fell over on the ground, and he started a whole lot of shaking going on and pounding the piano with his hands and kicking it with his feet, and the band went crazy, and the audience was half sat down. I was just sitting there stunned and shocked. Half the audience started to go crazy and dance in the aisles, just like you saw in those Alan Freed movies. Everyone left that night. This was at the Winnipeg Auditorium. Everybody left the night in somewhat of a shock, and there was this outrage at how dare this guy upset the stage, and like, what happened? This guy was an animal. And the next day on the radio, they played the track, a whole lot of shaking going on, over and over and over. Thank you. school at lunchtime and listen to the radio and hear this new, wild, crazy music, rock and roll. A friend in the north end of Winnipeg, I lived on Seven Oaks Avenue. A friend of mine, Shelley Ostro, his dad was an electrician, and let's just say his dad made more money than my dad. And he had a big purple Oldsmobile car with big chrome fins, and they had the first black and white TV on the block. Needless to say, after school every day, Shelley Ostro had a lot of friends. We'd go to his house and watch Range Rider, Howdy Doody, and on Saturday mornings we'd go and watch American Bandstand. And one Sunday night we got invited to watch the Ed Sullivan Show. It was a family variety show. And that's the first time I saw Elvis Presley on TV. That changed my life. That made me want to stop playing violin and pick up the guitar and learn to play this song. The first time I heard Tutti Frutti.
You know just what to do. So I'll to the east, you're all.